We want to solve the system of three equations with three unknowns using the method of elimination. Recall, when solving this type of system, there are three possible outcomes. We could have one solution, which would be an ordered triple. We can have no solution, or we can have infinite solutions. So going back to our system, let's go ahead and label the equations to keep things organized. We'll call the first equation, equation A, the second equation, equation B, the third equation, equation C. Notice equation B only contains two variables, y and z, which means if we add equation A and equation C and eliminate the x terms, we'll have two equations with two unknowns in the variables y and z. So our goal here is to add equations A and C and eliminate the x terms, which means we want the x terms to be opposites. Because equation C has positive 2x, we want the x term in the first equation, or equation A, to be negative 2x, which means we'll multiply equation A by negative 2 and then add it to equation C. So our first step is going to be to determine negative 2 times equation A plus equation C. Let's go ahead and multiply equation A by negative 2. That gives us negative 2x minus 2y minus 2z equals negative 4. Again, here I just multiplied the first equation, or equation A, by negative 2. And we're going to go ahead and leave equation C the same, which is 2x plus y plus 5z equals 0. And now we add these two equations together. And because the x terms are opposites, notice negative 2x plus 2x is 0. And then we have negative 2y plus y, which is negative y. And then we have negative 2z plus 5z, which is positive 3z, giving us plus 3z equals, on the right, negative 4 plus 0 is negative 4. So now we'll take this equation. Let's call this equation D. And equation B, and solve that as a system. So let's go ahead and rewrite equation D is negative y plus 3z equals negative 4. And equation B is y minus 3z equals 1. And now we want to eliminate either the y terms or z terms. But notice in this case, both the y terms and z terms are already opposites. So we don't have to multiply one or both equations by a constant. We can simply add the equations together. But notice in this case, negative y plus y is 0. And 3z plus negative 3z is also 0, giving us 0 equals negative 4 plus 1, which is negative 3. So whenever all the variables drop out and the resulting equation is false, which in this case we know 0 doesn't equal negative 3, this indicates the system has no solution. If the equation here was, for example, 0 equals 0, this would indicate the system has infinite solutions. But again, because all the variables are simplified out and the 0 doesn't equal negative 3, we now know the system has no solution. Which, remember, also indicates we can classify this system as inconsistent. If we look at the graph of these three equations in space, which will give us three planes in space, there won't be any points that are on all three planes. So here we see the graph of the three planes given by the three equations of the system, and there are no points that are on all three planes. You can see here there's this triangular region in the middle of all three planes. So our graph does verify the system has no solution. I hope you found this helpful.